simply trying to reach up and grab her hair, I'm not going to be able to. By dropping to a low horsepower, it's like I can reach up now and grab her wrist. As soon as I'm in that position, I use the same twisting movement that we used in dancing, but rather than not controlling the hands, I control the hand to come out of this position. As we're coming forward from here, this is an expression on the bridge, I step forward at a 45-degree angle. It's critical that I step forward at a 45-degree angle because I want to be in the same position from here you'd come in to punch. The best way to explain a mistake from here is to exaggerate it to the extreme, and that's exactly what I'm going to do. Rather than have my angle off just a few degrees, I'm going to change it drastically so you can see how I lose all the power. So your movement from here, coming off one, two. Let's zoom out low. You can see that I have absolutely no power as I come forward. And this is true to a greater degree as I move up. What I want to do is be in exactly the position I punch. I pull back from here with my left hand, come forward as I break against the right. If something has gone wrong from here, I carry this hand all the way high from here. Left hand out comes the cover nose. I have control of the center line of the body, elbow, and hammer fist. B version now. Too many times people have been trying to make a whole technique out of it, and to kick to the knee, they've changed the angle. The only reason we kick to the knee is because I pull out, but the opponent's leg will come forward from here so that I haven't got a clear shot. So what I do, I kick the knee out of the way.